My name is Rachel and I'm from Kingston School, Indonesia. In this presentation, we are going to talk about how we can protect our Earth. I'm going to start with the country where I live, Indonesia. We may live from different countries and continents, but we are all the same residents of this planet, which is our beloved Earth. Indonesia is located in the middle of the planet, which is the equator, and so it has only two seasons, the wet and dry seasons. Indonesia is also very famous for its paradise on earth, Bali, and also Komodo Island, where you can see real-life dragons in front of you. Why did I mention this in the opening of my presentation? Well, I would like to remind you, myself, and everyone here that our planet, the Earth, is such a beautiful planet. In fact, it is the only planet which can sustain a life in this galaxy. However, despite being the only beautiful and habitable planet, sadly, the Earth gets hotter gradually due to pollution and global warming. What exactly is global warming? Global warming is a condition when the Earth gets hotter due to climate changes. Global warming is caused mostly by littering, pollution, and deforestation. If we keep on continuing living this way, then global warming will be a serious threat to all living things on this planet. Thus, we have to protect our Earth starting now. There are several serious environmental problems and impacts of global warming, such as, first, littering in the ocean. I would like to encourage everyone here, please think before you act. Before you do any form of littering, think about the impacts you will cause and the souls you might kill as a result of your ignorance. Throwing plastics to the ocean can cause thousands of marine creatures to eat garbage and die. Additionally, birds also have plastics in their nests, and it was also reported that whales have eaten more than 200 pounds of plastic. Second, it's the usage of plastic. Did you know that just a single plastic took millions of years to decompose? They also release the toxic gas if you burn them. This is why the governments of many countries in the world have been applying a no plastic policy in supermarkets and shopping malls. We have also been encouraged to switch to metal drinking straws instead of the ones made of plastic. In order to be a hero and save our Earth, you need is just to simply switch your habit, and all of this begin from one simple thing called awareness. Then, let's talk about pollution. Globally, 91% of the world population is exposed to unhealthy levels of pollution. Pollution may muddy landscapes, poison soils and waterways, or kill plants and animals. Humans are also regularly harmed by pollution. Long-term exposure to air, for example, can lead to chronic respiratory disease, lung cancer, and other diseases. Now that you have known the factors which can harm our Earth, the question is, what should we do to save it? There are actually many different ways to help Earth. First, be responsible. If we all are more aware of exactly what items can or cannot be recycled, and we sort our waste accordingly, we are going to be ensuring that both our generation and future generations are still able to live and thrive on this beautiful planet of ours. After all, there is no planet B. Then, be wise. Use reusable bags or do the three R's: reuse, reduce, and recycle. In this modern era, you can even consider using a 3D printer to help you recycle your trash. Now, I'm going to show you one of the examples of recycling, like
making a terrarium out of plastic bottles. See, these items don't need to be thrown away. You could make it again into beautiful things.
Reduce pollution. Try use a bicycle, walking, or public transport more often. Also, don't burn leaves or trash because they release carbon dioxide and smoke. In conclusion, we should protect the environment to stop further damage to the earth. Why? Because Earth is the only planet that has life in it. Earth is our home. Just like how you protect your house from fire and destruction, you should also be protecting Earth in the same way. Like what Franklin D. Roosevelt said, a nation that destroys its soil destroys itself. Forests are the lungs of our land, purifying the air and giving fresh strength to our people. Ask yourself this question. If not now, when? If not me, who? It should begin from yourself. Thank you for watching. I'm Rachel, now signing off. Let's do our part to protect our home.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place can be much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space.